5:31. And our first order of business, item of business, is discussion and action on the minutes from July 17th. Is there any discussion?
I move we approve the minutes.
Second.
Oh, it says July 19th.
On the minutes, it says.
On the minutes, on the agenda, it says July 17th.
It says 17th.
Okay.
And I don't know which ones are right.
Minutes have got it right, though.
The minutes have got it right, so, okay.
We're all right.
My bad.
So, okay.
Terry.
Aye.
Scott.
Melinda.
Aye.
And Angelica.
Yes.
Okay, next order of business is the June financial report. So you guys will look over that.
I think why we tabled those was because we didn't have all of the
all the ones that cleared already, or we're getting ready to clear.
Yep,
it just wasn't.
Yep, that's what it was. So I went and talked to Tatum when we got all those figured out, and they're added on to the July financial, and then I gave Melinda the updated ones that have not been paid out yet.
Okay.
So that's why we tabled those.
Yep. So it looks like we have, and so these are on the July and August
mm-hmm.
report. Okay. So it looks like we have five events that haven't been paid out yet.
Mm-hmm.
So the Chamber of Commerce MOU for 33-229, the Alva High School shootout, which isn't going to even happen until December, for $5,000, the Cruise and Car Show $28,700, the Nescatunga Golf Tournament $6,000, and the Mural Fest $66,51.55. So
the golf tournament's already happened though, right?
The Nescatunga Golf Tournament, yes, happened June the 7th and 8th.
They just haven't
turned their stuff in.
I've reached out to them. I'll do it again.
So, anyway. Is there any more discussion on the June financial report? Do we have a motion?
I'll move to approve the June financial report.
Second.
Second.
Angelica seconded.
Okay.
I was asking, is there a second? That's what I was asking. So.
Okay. Scott?
Aye.
Angelica?
Yes.
Terry?
Aye.
Melinda?
Aye. Okay. And then the July financial report. And we did not table this one. We just haven't met since
right.
This one's been available because our August meeting, there were no applications. So I just will point out on this one that's different from the June financial report that they have taken into the CD number 479-0077 that it actually is tagged for the arena. And there is $150,000 in it. So that'll help us remember what that is.
So they've moved stuff around.
They've moved stuff around.
Perfect.
And put it in there. And that way, that's what we're going to owe when that happens. And that will, we have that set aside. So I like it when we have things set aside.
Mm-hmm.
So
yes.
for stuff like that.
Yes.
So, okay, any discussion on the July financial report?
So that was just pool cash money.
Well, there was actually a CD that had most of that in it, and then they moved a little bit of the cash into
that's
that
right.
to make it $150,000.
Yeah, that's the same.
So
it shows in the pool cash. That,
yeah.
So it's still the total investments is still there.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Figured that's what we did.
Yeah. I just wanted it to be there without question.
Yeah. No, I remember.
When it happens. So.
I remember doing it. So.
So, any other discussion? Do we have a motion?
I'll move to approve the July finance.
Second.
Scott?
Yeah.
Jill? Terry?
Aye.
Melinda?
And then, August. Jenny, thank you for meeting with her and getting that all straightened out.
Oh, yeah, no problem. Glad it was brought to my attention.
Is there a discussion on the August financial report?
I just want to verify that, okay, the 186, 195, it's that minus all of this, right? Is how much we have?
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't do that.
No, it's fine. No, you're fine. Just,
I wrote that, I made that in, I guess that was July. And so then I took off before I came to the meeting of which one's paid. So then I was like, oh, I don't have time to put the numbers.
It's fine. I just wanted to verify that.
Yeah.
So.
I can do that for next meeting. So.
Is there any question on the August financial report?
I move we approve the August financial report.
Terry?
Aye.
Scott?
Aye.
Angelica?
Yes.
Lord?
Yes. And they gave us a little update. Oh, well, I had it in my hand just a second ago. A little update on the collections for the quarter ending June 30th. So you guys can all look at that page. And I wanted to give you a little update. There was a discussion at the city council meeting about the verbiage on the ordinance and what the Oklahoma Tax Commission wants and what the city council wants, and they're really kind of working that out. Steve sent me a message and said that he felt like they were getting close. And so hopefully he'll have something by the time we meet next month.
Did they say specifically what the...
The issue is that there are some people living in the motels who have been there longer than just an overnight stay. So some of them, that is their home. Mm-hmm. And they've lived there for longer than 30 days, I think is what the ordinance says. And so they've lived there longer than that. And... the original spirit of that tax wasn't to charge those people,
right,
you know, the rent. So I think they're trying to work that out.
I just was curious.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Okay.
And I think that's really a valid question, you know. So so anyway, they're working on that. I think they're all at some municipal lead thing this week, learning more about city government. So that's great. So hopefully by the time we meet next month, I think our meeting's on
18th.
The 18th, mm-hmm. Yeah. So that gives them quite a bit of time to figure that out. So.
And the week of their city council.
Yes, the week of their city council meeting. Good. So they'll meet two more times before, two more regular meetings before we meet again. So hopefully they'll have something for that. So, okay. Let's see. The next item on the agenda is the discussion and action on the Salt Fork June Jam and the art on the Salt Fork show and sale. So, Kay, I think you're up.
All right. This event was last held in 2021. We did not do it last year. We thought Nascatunga would be back downtown, and so we kind of planned toward that. That didn't happen. We need to have an arts-related event downtown Alba every summer. It's important for the merchants to have that traffic. And so we're bringing this back, and it will be on Friday evening, June 21st, through the end of the day on June 22nd of 2024. So it'll be a Friday, all-day Saturday thing. It will be all around downtown. I've listed the locations. Performances, of course, be on the courthouse stage. Arts and vendors will be the gallery at the Runnymede, round sidewalks. Kind of depends on what they have and what they need in the way of if they're planning to stay over and they'll probably want to be inside so they can lock everything up. The theme of this is our Western heritage, and the feature performance will be Oklahoma Swing. This is what the Byron Berline Band has become. Byron passed away due to COVID a couple of years ago. His band has remained together, and they're still performing all over the state, and so they were happy to come back. They were here in 2021, I believe, is when they came. And so they're happy to come back. We are working on getting the Black Salt Fork blacksmithing group to come back to Alva. They originated here and now are based out of Perry. Rope makers, saddle makers, all the things that go with our Western heritage, as well as fine art and crafts. So that's what this will be, and we are going to, of course, invite some food trucks. We're going to go forward with what I think needs to be happening anyway, and that is ensuring that all vendors have a sales tax permit with the state of Oklahoma, and if they're serving food, that they meet health department certification, and that is posted in their place of business. So that will be a couple of the things that we're going to require as part
That's
of the
great.
It needs to happen. And,
well, and I think Steve's even mentioned that with the food trucks.
I'm working with him on that. gave him how five different communities in Oklahoma are doing it so that we can be in alignment with everybody else. Of course, the city could be charging a permit, and that's something that I think they're probably going to look at hard. But when you've got brick and mortar places that are doing what they're supposed to do, and then you have mobile vendors of all stripes that you were not able to track whether they are in fact collecting and paying their sales tax, we need to make sure that's happening. So we'll be doing that. And anyway, we've requested funding support in the past, and I'm requesting funding support again this year from tourism tax. We do have an application in at the Oklahoma Arts Council, and that amount is for $4,000. So that's where we are. What questions do you have?
So this will be three weeks after, 2 weeks after Nescatunga?
Don't know about Nescatunga.
Okay. Usually they're the first weekend.
They're usually the first Saturday, but
don't know. Okay. And we haven't heard from them yet. So, I mean, this committee hasn't heard from them yet.
Right.
About next year, so
yeah.
I don't know what they're doing. So.
So we're going ahead, and you can't wait till the last minute to book performances. You've got to get on it. And so we already know that the band is spending the night. They've asked me to book rooms, and I won't be booking rooms, but they will. I don't book rooms for people. Most of our artists do. And just so you guys know, throughout the year, we typically have anywhere from 3 to 5 of our artists for First Friday or their family members spend the night here. That's just what they do. And then we have people from all over that come to Alva to tour the different public art pieces, come to First Friday, etc. So the arts do have an impact, and it will have an impact on this event. As far as hotel rooms go.
Sounds like a fun event. So thank you for your work on this.
Sure. Thank you, Sarah. Any other questions?
Any questions for
them? I would move to approve the Salt Fork Jam Jam and Art on the Salt Fork Show and Sale in an amount not to exceed $4,000.
Second.
Angelica?
Yes.
Terry?
Aye.
Scott?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you all. Appreciate it.
Thank you. You're not Stockton, but I guess you're presenting, Dan.
I am presenting, yes.
I'd like to see you.
Good evening. Yes, I'm presenting on behalf of Stockton Graves. He, during one of his competitions, exploded his knee, and he went and had surgery yesterday. So he is recovering. So I'm gonna.
Is he doing okay?
Yeah, I texted him a while ago. He's home. He will not be a patient. I think it's maybe the best way to put it. And I say that with all due respect, Stockton. But he will recover and be back. You have before you the application for our annual Northwestern Rodeo. We're asking again for the $15,000 to help offset the stock contractors. We presented a budget to you of how the monies will be spent and what revenue would come in. A few highlights that Stockton and I talked about, we're expecting again between 750 and 800 contestants that will come into Alva to compete one or more days. Northwestern is centrally located within our region, and we typically have one of the highest participation rates, one, because of where we're located, and second, because I think Northwestern puts on a great rodeo for those participants. They also, he started this a couple years ago, will have the, what he calls a match of champions, where some of our former athletes that are competing at the professional level will come back and compete with some of our students for some of the entertainment that will be on Saturday night. And then, as always, on Wednesday, the rodeo team will be downtown with their animals and things with the middle school or with the children on the square. I always tell folks, probably next to homecoming, this is the largest event that Northwestern hosts that I think brings in the biggest economic impact to our community. And well, I'm certainly proud to help be part of that. So with that, I'll ask any questions. Pretty cut and dry. A lot of work goes into it, but a lot of rewards come out of it.
I love that they show the animals to the school kids. I think that's always really neat.
Yes.
It's a really neat part
and
of it.
And I think our, what I've seen, I think our athletes get as much or more out of it as the children do. I think it's a great learning opportunity for the community and Northwestern to come together.
I think it's really cool.
Yeah.
So I'm really glad that they do that. And how big is your rodeo team? That doesn't matter in this, but like...
Oh, I didn't get the final number. We try to have between 90 and 110.
Yeah, that's a big student group.
Yeah, it's a large group. And I know Stockton was recruiting, and the team was recruiting all summer. I hadn't heard the final number.
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
I thought it was probably about that, but yeah. Okay. Any other questions for David?
Thank you very much.
I would just like to mention that I think we've passed an ordinance or something that's going to go into effect that you need to buy way in advance next year.
Yeah, it has to be 90 days before the start of the event.
Okay, just a reminder.
Yeah, no,
so that'll be like, if it's at the end of October, probably by the June, by our June meeting?
Yeah, we've already reached out to the couple groups that come before this committee.
Yeah,
so
okay.
We will adjust.
Okay.
Not a challenge.
So, well, I move we approve $15,000 for the
reminders.
Northwestern Rodeo.
Second. Terry?
Aye.
Angelica?
Yes.
Scott?
Yes.
And Melinda?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. Are there any remarks from, or reports from staff? Okay. And any remarks or inquiries by committee members? Okay. Well, we've done this really quickly.
That was a quick one.
I move that we adjourn.
Yeah. Second. I don't think we have to do that.
I guess we don't have to do that anymore.
But so. I still